iButton reader connection and configuration for engine locking feature. In this tutorial, we will show you how to connect an iButton reader to Ruptela FM device. Also, we will show you how to configure your device to prepare it for the driver identification, which will allow it to unblock vehicle's engine. Note that engine blocking feature also requires relay installation. That was described in previous video tutorial. In this tutorial, we will be using an iButton reader, standard device package from Ruptela with FM device, 12 and 14 pins connectors, and a GPS GLONASS antenna. USB cable, type A to B mini for device configuration. Take the 12-pin connector and find red and black wires attached to first and second pins. This is the power supply wires for the FM device. Strip the wire ends. Take the black wire and attach it to negative pole of your power supply unit. Then attach the red wire to positive pole. Now, on the 14-pin connector, we will need one wire data and ground wires. Black wire attached to the second pin on the 14-pin connector is a ground wire. Green wire with yellow stripe is a data transmission wire. It is attached to the 6th pin of the connector. Strip the ends of both of them. Take your iButton reader. It has two differently colored wires. Strip wire ends. Take a brown wire to connect it to the black wire on the 14-pin connector. Now take the white wire and connect it to the green-yellow wire on the 14-pin connector. Note: insulate all wire connections. For real-world applications, we recommend using specialized insulation methods that ensure reliable long-term performance under harsh field conditions. Heat shrink connectors, crimped solder wire connectors, insulating tape, or similar materials can be used. Plug 14 and 12-pin connectors to the device. It will power up and it will be ready for configuration. Plug one end of USB cable to the FM device's mini USB port and the other one to the PC. We will be using FM4 configurator and a standard configuration file for FMTC04 HCV. Both of them can be downloaded from doc.ruptela.lt. Launch the FM4 configurator. Choose your device. In the upper menu, click File, open CFG, and select Standard Configuration File, which you have previously downloaded. Note that different devices use different configuration files. Only configurations compatible with this device can be chosen. Before proceeding, you must provide additional information. First of all, in the Global Settings section, fill the Connection Settings field. Enter your server IP address and port number. Secondly, choose a protocol. UDP or TCP protocols can be chosen. Finally, enter APN settings provided to you by the GSM GPRS provider. Note, in this video, values entered in the IP address, port number, and APN names fields are used only as an example. During registration, an iButton ID is read by the FM device. Vehicle's engine can be started only after registration with a specific iButton that has a valid ID. ID numbers that are allowed to do so are kept in the authorized IDs list. Here, you can enter card ID, iButton authorization numbers. Go to Authorized ID section. Put a tick in the checkbox if it is not already checked. Then click the Options button. Enter Authorized ID numbers and close the window. For driver registration to function, we need to enable iButton ID IO parameter. Only then it will get the driver's ID to the server. In Profile Settings, click on Options button in the IO Events section. In the IO Settings window, choose an empty slot for a new parameter. Put a tick on the Enable checkbox. In the IO list, find and select iButton driver ID. Event on, change, priority, high. For the ignition blocking relay control, we need to enable the device's digital outputs. It must be the same digital output that was used to connect the relay. In their section, use drop-down menu, next to the required out, and choose blocking. Close the IO settings window. Now we can move to the driver registration section. Click on Options button. For registration function, select blocking. In output section, on the middle of the window, put a tick and enable blocking checkbox. Registration source section left should be set to iButton. When all of these are selected, close registration settings window. It is time to upload the configuration to the device. Choose a COM port when your device is connected and click Connect button. Send configuration to FM device and disconnect from it. Once all of the steps are complete, only drivers with valid IDs will be able to start the engine. Driver's ID will be shown in the TrustTrack reports.